Hi guys, and welcome to the first part of how to become a webcam model. I'm UKDAZZZ, and I've been a webcam model, if you haven't seen my intro video, for the last four, maybe five years, on and off, and just answering and going over a few topics that I get asked regularly. So to start off with today, we're going to go through equipment. Sounds obvious, a webcam model, you need obviously the very basics is your webcam, fast internet, and a laptop or PC. So a lot of websites or webcamming sites do offer the ability to stream from your phone. And although this is really handy, it's probably not the best way of doing it. It doesn't provide the best quality of your live streams. So obviously, customers in mind, you really do need quite a good setup to get yourself going. It doesn't necessarily have to be the most expensive setup, but good equipment is, yeah, it's a necessity. So to start off with, go for a fast internet provider, as fast as you can. The reason for this is because you do stream a lot of data, and you need to be able to send it as fast and receive it just as fast. Because a lot of sites at the moment are supporting and pushing cam to cam, which is obviously two-way webcamming, where you can see the client can see you. Second of all, obviously you need a fast laptop. Once again, this is because a lot of sites, as I say, are promoting cam to cam. This does take a big strain on your laptop or on your PC. If you're using a phone, the phone doesn't support cam to cam, so that puts a lot of clients off. And thirdly, you need obviously a webcam. I use the Logitech C920, amazing little bit of kit. I also use a generic off-brand, and both are really good. The Logitech beats it hands down. So it's an idea to spend the money on it. The reason the Logitech is better is because the quality of the camera, not necessarily the clarity of it, because the generic off-brand is still 1080, so it's full HD, that's what you need. But the camera angle is wider, so it picks up more of the room, which is a little bit, you see a bit too much of what's going on around you. Also, contrast on the cheaper one is not as good. The brightness of the webcam under the wrong lights, it just doesn't, like, I'm fairly tanned at the moment. That cheap generic webcam doesn't pick up that color unless you've got a program like OBS, which you can adjust the colors yourself. The actual Logitech one does that for you. It adjusts the brightness, it adjusts all the contrast, so you look as good as you do, where the generic off-brand doesn't actually do that. But it's nonetheless, if you've only got a small budget, I think that one was 25 quid, and as I say, it's a good cam, it is a really good cam. But the Logitech one, especially the C920, is really good for picking up contrast. It's just clearer, it looks nicer, and yeah, looks really good. So if you've got a bit of more of a budget, and you've got more money to spend on better equipment at the moment, Logitech are doing their 4K HD camera, which is absolutely amazing. As long as you've got the right kit, like the right laptop, the right internet speed, all the sites at the moment are pushing 4K and HD, obviously. So the bare minimum you need is a HD camera. Don't use your laptop's camera. Don't use your phone. It just creates a really bad, like, if I'm doing this when I'm typing to you around the screen, you can see that, the client can see that, they can see you on a phone. A lot of people don't use stands, I've seen, so the phone's slipping while they're on the cam. It just makes no sense. So to have a proper setup is just, you've got to do it. There's no two ways about it. Everything you can get reasonably cheap. So there's no real excuse to use a to use your mobile phone. I don't use it. I've tried it just to see, because as a bit of a gimmick. But as I say, I didn't like having to type the screen, the client seeing what I'm doing, and yeah, just sort of taking away from that experience, because it's not, it works well, but overall quality for the client, I certainly wouldn't pay to watch someone do that on the screen, because it's not really worth it. It's to have a proper setup is what you need. Now, other things you want to consider when setting up is your tripod, lighting, and a remote keyboard or Bluetooth keyboard. Those sort of things make it easier for you, and especially the keyboard, because one, you need good lighting, positioning your camera is key. You might not want something shown in the background, you want to be able to move it around as easily as possible. And for the keyboard, if I'm sat close like this and typing away, it goes back to getting using a mobile phone, I've got to be quite close to the camera if I'm typing. With the remote keyboard, I can sit back here, type away here, and not get nowhere near the actual camera, and it keeps the quality of the stream going. It makes it smoother, it makes it easier. If you can talk on cam, if you live in quite a, if you're not in a house yet, the people around you know what you're up to, by all means speak, because customers love hearing your voice. Doesn't matter where you're from, English people love Americans, Americans love the English. If you've got a great French accent, everyone loves that. Every single person loves a great French accent, Italian. So just speak. If you can't speak, definitely invest your money in like a wireless keyboard, because it just makes a big difference. The quality of being able to sit back, relax, type if you need to type, and not have to get up in the cam's face, just makes a massive difference. And I've linked all the products and stuff that I use in the description. Yes, they're affiliate links, so I do get a little bit of money of it, but obviously that doesn't affect the price for you. It just means I can keep funding videos. But yeah, it's just a basic setup you need. You don't need loads of stuff, and it's not particularly expensive. But just having the right equipment just makes such a big difference for the customer's experience, and not only for the customer's experience, it makes it easier for you. So as I say, having the right lighting, that makes a big difference for everyone. To get that right, you know, it makes the difference between someone being able to see you clearly, and it's just so much easier to have good equipment. And as I say, it doesn't have to be expensive, but just good equipment that does the job. So as I say, I've listed all the items that I use in the description below. I've also added stuff like sex toys if you don't mind using sex toys. Lovency, I think they're called. They do like a range of wireless sex toys. They're listed in the description below. That'll be covered in another video. Along with just like a regular sex toy, you can go to any shop and buy them. There is a link down below again from a company that deliver sex toys all around the world within, I think the maximum is like 5 to 6 days, depending on where you are. In the US they deliver in 2 days. I think in the UK they deliver in 2 days. I think in Europe it's about five. But yeah, just a few links that will help, and a few items that you might want to consider. But we'll go over sex toys in another video. So in the meantime, I think that's everything I wanted to cover in today's video. Feel free to subscribe, hit the notifications, and if you've got any questions, just drop me a message. I'll answer them either on Instagram. They're all listed, the ways to contact me in my description as well. So yeah, I think that's everything, and I'll see you next time, which will be probably a video on webcam insights, who to use, who to trust. I use two, just go over it briefly. I use two, I use StreamMate and I use Chatterbait primarily. And I use Sky Private and my own website. But links to those are in the description as well, so you can sign up for before the next video, which will cover all the things you need to know on what information you provide in and stuff like that. So until next time, which will be probably in the next couple of days, I will see you later. Peace out.